I'm Graham Johnson. I'm a medical illustrator and more recently got a PhD in biophysics. And I've come here to UCSF to work as a faculty fellow running a lab that builds computational tools to make it easier to visualize molecular and cellular biology. As a principal investigator, I run a lab with several other people in it, and I do a bit of programming myself, but at this stage, I spend a lot of time writing grants, writing papers, and thinking about the bigger pictures of what tools and projects we want to work on, and then working with the people in my lab to figure out what their strengths are and what their interests are and try to develop those projects to meet their needs or to apply the best people to meet the needs of the project. I still do a lot of illustration and animation work. We're heading into the third edition of a cell biology textbook that I've done all the illustrations for. I love just solving problems, and I rarely enjoy doing the same thing twice. And because this field of molecular visualization and modeling and simulation is kind of the Wild West, almost everything we do has never been done before, so it's a real challenge every day. It can be frustrating because we have to spend a lot of time explaining what we do, validating it, and as opposed to having previous work to build on and templates to build on like that. But it's rewarding when we finally break through and convince a lot of people that what we're doing is exciting. So, I like what we do because we get to look at the big picture of science. We get to take all of the amazing results of hundreds of thousands of labs over the years and try to piece them back together to retell the whole story of cell biology with molecular detail, to be able to see, literally see, as well as understand the three-dimensional models that we construct to see all this data coming back together to emulate what we believe is going on down at the level that we cannot directly observe, but that's beyond the limits of microscopy, or at least pushes the limits of microscopy. Broadly speaking, in science, the most people get excited about the discovery aspect of it, to learn something that no one has known about before, or to describe something in greater detail than has ever been known or described before.